In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract information from websites and put it into Home Assistant. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and today we're going to use a scrape sensor to extract information from websites and input it into Home Assistant. So let's get going. So what is a scrape sensor? Well, a scrape sensor will load a website behind the scenes, and then based on some CSS selectors that you give it, it'll then extract information relevant to those CSS selectors from the website, depending on what's tagged. Let's have a look at an actual website and its source code to see what we mean further. This is the source code for the Home Assistant homepage. As you can see, in this code, the content is split down into lots of sections and lots of subsections, and then sub-subsections, and then you know how it goes. And each of these sections, or a lot of these sections, are labeled with a class. But some of these sections don't have any labeling at all. For example, this H1. You can also have sections labeled with an ID instead. It depends on how the website is built. By using these CSS selectors, we can extract the information within those tags. By having a look at the W3 Schools website, we can see a long list of different selectors that we can use. For example, for a class, you put a dot before the name. For an ID, you put a hashtag before the name. And for an element, you just leave it as it is. We can then use different operators, or just a space, to combine different sections, depending on how we want to navigate through the source code. We can also download an add-on from the Chrome extension store called CSS Selector Tester. This is great for checking that the selector you've chosen will actually spit out the right information. If we have a look at the Home Assistant website, let's say we wanted to extract the current version information. If we right-click on it and click Inspect, we can see the source code. And from here, we can see that the current version has its own class called current version. So we could use the selector .current-version. And if we use the tester, we can see it selects this whole section. What if we wanted to go down even further? As we can see, the actual version number is in a separate H1 category. So if we use .current-version space H1, then we'll just get the current version number and not the line below it at all. So let's implement this into our Home Assistant. We're going to need to add a new scrape sensor. My sensors are referenced elsewhere, so we're going to go there. The platform is scrape, we give it a name, a resource, which is the website, and a select. These are the CSS selectors that you're going to use. These want to be in quote marks. Now we can head over to the website that we want to scrape from to populate that information. For this example, I'm going to use the next waste bin collection day for this random house in Herefordshire. If we right-click on the information we want, click Inspect, it'll bring up the source code. Now we can see the information for this section is in an HC island, so we could use that as our scrape sensor, but that will gather all of that information that's inside the HC island, and that's not necessarily what we want. What we can see is the date itself, which is the information that we actually want, has got a separate ID of alt next waste day, so we can use that as our selector. We'll put that into our CSS selector tester using a hashtag because it's an ID, and we can check that it spits out the right information, or at least highlights the right information in this case. If we put that as our select in quote marks and the website address as our resource, then our scrape sensor should work. It's worth noting that for the scrape sensor to work, all the information needs to be visible straight away. It's no good if you have to click on a drop-down button, for example, or re-enter your postcode every time you reload the page, because the scrape sensor just won't work. An example of this is if we look at the Cornish website for bin collection. As you can see, when we load this page, although it is unique to the postcode, you get a please wait while it's loading notification in the section where it would load. This won't work for a scrape sensor because it will scrape that information, or separate information entirely, instead of waiting for the bin information to load and then scraping that. If we put the scrape information and the URL back into our sensor entity in our config, then we can save, check config, and restart Home Assistant. Then the sensor should be appearing in our integrations. Now let's do another one. I'm going to indulge slightly here and create a scrape sensor that gets the number of subscribers to my YouTube channel. Now it's worth noting that some websites don't work with scrape sensors. YouTube is one of them. This is because the website knows that the scrape sensor isn't actually a person, so it will block the channel. There is a fix for this, but again, it only works on some websites. The thing with the scrape sensor is the more simple the website, the more likely it is that the scrape sensor will work. If your website is really complicated and hidden inside JavaScript and all sorts, then your scrape sensor won't work at all. So, let's add a new scrape sensor. We give it a name, we give it a resource, and we give it a select, as we did with the last one. Now let's head over to Social Blade, where we're going to get this information from. We want the subscriber count, so we select that, right click, and click Inspect. As you can see, this information is inside a YouTube User Top Info class. But so is other information in this section. But if we go inside, we can see that there's another span which doesn't display, which has this same number in it. And this has a separate ID. So let's use that instead. We need to remember to use the hashtag because it's an ID. Let's input that and the resource website back into our scrape sensor. We can save, check config, and restart Home Assistant. This time, when we have a look in our integrations, the scrape sensor has spit out unknown. This could be for multiple reasons, including getting the wrong selector. But in this case, I know it's because the website is banning the scrape sensor from working. I said there was a simple fix to this. All we need to do is add these two lines of code to the bottom of our scrape sensor, and that will trick the website into thinking that the scrape sensor is actually a person. As I said, it won't work on all websites, but in this case, I know it works. So we add these two lines in, save, check config, and restart Home Assistant. We go back into our integrations, and we can see the right value has appeared. Of course, once the data is inside Home Assistant, we can do what we like with it. We could plot it in a graph, we could use a template sensor to extract certain information from it, or we could use it to trigger automations. All the code I've written today will be on my GitHub and linked below. So there we have it. We've extracted website information and added it as a sensor into Home Assistant. Make sure you hit subscribe and click the bell icon below to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.